get up and do my thing. One, two, three, four. Get up,
get on up.
Get up,
get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up
like a sex machine.
Get on up.
This is Gio and Jones on CBS Sports Radio.
Get up.
And we're coming to you live from the O'Reilly Auto Parts studio. O'Reilly Auto parts, better prices every day. Greg Giannotti, Brian Jones, Gio and Jones across the country on CBS Sports Radio.
Media icon.
That's right.
Media icon. Thank you, Dean Bernhard.
Yeah, media icon, Brian Jones. So as we were just explaining, it was a little while ago that we made some new friends out in Latvia, Translitteris, the rap group that put together that phenomenal Kristaps Porzingis song that went all over, it went viral, and we had him on a couple times, and at that point, everything was great with Kristaps. He was playing great, everybody loved him, there's no problems. At this point, though, there's some issues, as Kristaps and the Knicks apparently had an impasse. So we're not getting the good reporting we need. So we decided to call upon our Latvian friend.
Go to the source.
That's right. Edzus Kalkulis of Translitteris to try to figure out what's going on. Edzus, good morning or good afternoon or good night, wherever the hell you are. Edzus, how's it going, man?
Hello, guys. Good to hear you. Good to hear you. Very nice that you call me.
Yes.
It's afternoon. It's afternoon.
Oh, right? Cool. Okay. So you remember us?
Of course I remember you. I also promised that I will come to you, to your studio, but as you see, I'm still sitting in my hood and preparing new songs.
So. Oh, he's still in his hood.
Yeah,
he's gotcha,
still,
baby.
Still in his hood.
Yeah, well, you're always welcome in our hood.
Yeah, okay, I'll be there, I promise you.
Yeah.
Now, will Porzingis be here in this hood? Is he still happy with New York and specifically the New York Knicks?
Wow, I don't know where he is right now. Is he in New York or no?
Don't play coy with us,
Edzus. I know where is he, I know. He is back in Latvia. Guys, don't worry, everything is okay with him. I don't know what kind of mess did he make there.
Well, I don't...
But here in Latvia, everything is okay. I don't know if you noticed, but he's got 1 million followers in Instagram. Mm. He's celebrating this. He's making everyday Insta stories. He's even boxing right now with our famous boxer, Mairis Briedis. He is doing everything. His brother has got his own restaurant. I don't know if he's coming back to New York, guys. Everything is okay with
everything is beautiful in Latvia. You can just stay there.
Okay.
Well.
No. Okay, it's okay. Let's be honest. I know that one guy from New York Knicks sent him a text message and he didn't answer, and that's the story, yeah?
Yeah, well, yes. that is part of the story, yes. And apparently he skipped his exit meeting with the Knicks organization as well. In the Latvian circles, is the scuttlebutt that Kristaps is upset with the Knicks organization?
What? I don't think so. He's a new guy. I don't know. He's 21 or 23, something like this, yeah? This time, for Latvian guys, this is a summer like a season, and no one is doing nothing. No one is studying. No one is working. Everyone is chilling out. So don't worry, guys. Everything is okay with him, and I think he will come back to New York. Don't worry. He's just relaxing.
Okay, so you're saying it basically everyone chill out because this is what we do in Latvia. We're off the radar. We're off the grid. We just want to enjoy our summer. Just because we don't return your text message doesn't mean we're still not fond of you, correct?
Yes.
All right, simple as that. Well, very good.
But guys, as you remember from last year, we also start conversation, our group, me and my friend Lauris, band Translitteris. We also made a conversation, started it with New York Knicks. They send us a message, we send them back, and they just, I don't know, where did they go? And,
yeah.
We also waiting a message from them. Maybe Kristaps is doing the same.
Oh.
He will come back in September or I don't know when the season starts. Okay, it doesn't matter. He will come back to New York and then call this guy. I don't know. It will be okay. Don't worry.
This is payback because the Knicks didn't call you back, right?
Yeah.
That's right. He's sticking up for his boys.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, don't mess with Latvians.
We're talking to Edzus Kaukulis, half of Translateris, as we're going straight to the source out in Latvia to figure out what the heck's going on with Kristaps. Now, another part of this controversy was that on Twitter, he tweeted out L.A. Clippers with a bunch of smiling emojis. Now, we know he plays for the Knicks. He doesn't play for the Clippers. And he tweets this out. He claimed that his Twitter account was hacked. What do you know about that?
Of course it was hacked.
Oh, really?
What do you think? Of course. For example, when my wife sees my browsing history, I always say that it's hacked.
You have to throw him off the scent, right?
Of course it was hacked.
Ed Zeus, you're playing coy with us here. I'm thinking that there really is a problem with Kristaps. And Draymond Green of the Warriors said that his theory was Kristaps got drunk and was having a good time in Latvia because this is the time where everybody is chilling, no school, no work, as you said. That he got drunk and he decided to write that and tweet it out. And he wasn't thinking about what he was doing and then quickly deleted it and then claimed that he got hacked. Is there any truth to that rumor?
I don't think so.
Okay.
First of all, I don't think that he's a drinker.
Okay.
I don't think so. And in that time, he wasn't in Latvia. He was in Spain with his friends. I don't know. Maybe it wasn't alcohol. It was just wine or something. Nobody drinks wine in Spain. They're drinking wine every day, and it was, I don't know, maybe a little bit more or something. I don't know. But he's a good boy. He's a good boy. Don't worry. And one more thing.
Sure.
I think you don't have to worry. He will come back to New York, and he will be there because he already bought a new flat there. New apartment.
Mm-hmm. Well, when did he buy that new flat?
I don't know. A few months ago.
Okay.
Or is he renting?
Oh, I don't know. Well, that's an important distinction, though,
right?
Ed Zeus, if he buys an apartment as opposed to renting it.
Yeah, and all his family is living there. Even his brother has got a new girlfriend from New York City. It can't be possible that he will move out. It's tiring. It's annoying. It can't be that he can go to L.A. next year or year after. He will stay in New York. He loves the city, and everyone loves him also there. Or isn't true or what?
No. Everybody, they love him. But I'm just worried about the Knicks organization themselves screwing it up because, as you know, they're just an awful organization. They don't even get back to you. They should have had you performing at Madison Square Garden. They should have taken advantage of that. They don't know how to do anything right. So every New York Knicks fan loves Kristaps. We're just afraid that the Knicks are going to screw it up.
If Kristaps wants to play in playoffs, of course he has to change the club. But I think he loves New York City so much that he will stay there. And how his jerseys are selling? Everything is okay,
right? No, yeah. Zeus, that's fine. You keep saying he loves New York. Does he love the Knicks?
Does he love the Knicks? I think he loves blue color. I think it's a good color, and also the Madison Square Garden is like a great place and everything. But the team, I don't know.
Oh, we're talking to Edzus Kaukulis of Translateris, our favorite Latvian rap pop group. Have you seen Kristaps about town? Have you seen him? Have you hung out with him? Do you guys sit around and talk amongst yourselves?
No, he's got a lot of friends right now in Latvia. Imagine he's a first-class star right now. And we are not searching places where to find him and see him. We saw him last year. In one event and say hello and everything, and that's all.
Okay.
He's not like our best friend or what, but He's a good guy, I think.
I hope so. Yeah. I hope so. Mm-hmm. All right. So, so Ed Zeus, any new music that we need to know about? Because we've loved everything that you've put out. Is there anything new that we can listen to while we're driving home?
You want English or you also want
both? It's fine. Right, I mean, yeah. Your Kristaps Porzingis song was mostly not in English, right. So
we want good beats.
Yeah, we like everything.
We have something, but right now we are working on it, and it's quite a long time while we don't have like published nothing. So we are working and waiting for a real moment to put everything out, and I'm definitely sure that you will also hear it. So stay in touch, and you will get new hits from us.
All right, great. Hey, Ed Zeus, thanks for the time this morning. Man. Keep in touch. If you get any other gossip or facts or anything on Kristaps and the Knicks, you get to us right away, all right?
Yeah, and then I also want to invite you to our event. It's in Cēsis, small city or local town in Fono Clubs. Come here, I can get you a free ticket. We can discuss something more about these Twitter things.
Wait, hold on. So what's the name of the town?
Cēsis. Sounds silly, Cēsis. It's a nice name.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. I can't figure. How do you, can you spell it for us?
C-E-S-I-S.
Okay.
Cēsis.
Okay.
Cēsis.
And when is this event?
June 16.
Oh, wow. Mm. Okay.
Now, this is a concert?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a concert, yeah.
Okay.
Really big show from us, so come here. I'll give you free tickets. Don't worry. You can bring your friends with us.
Lots of tall models?
Yeah, if you want, local models.
Lots of models.
Now Brian is a very large black man. Is he going to go over well in Cēsis?
Sorry, one more time.
Brian's a very large black man. Is he
black man? Yeah. Yeah. We have seen them. Jeez, yeah.
Oh!
We have a lot of them.
So you're
yes, we've spotted a few.
So it's not going to scare you then.
Sorry, it was a bad joke.
No,
no, it was
good,
funny.
Baby.
It was funny.
That's fine.
You don't need to apologize to us. We love you, Ed Zeus.
Yeah, we spotted a few.
We will cut this out. Yeah.
No, it's too late.
It's fine. It's fine. Ed Zeus, you are a funny man. You're a great guy. Thank you for the time this morning, and we'll be in touch. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Right. There he goes. Oh yeah, we spotted a few.
Ed Zeus Kalkoulis.
Taking all our women.
Translateris. Giving us the scoop on what's going on with Kristaps Porzingis out in Latvia. So
I think there's trouble on the horizon.
Yeah, I mean, I know that Ed Zeus is a guy who likes to make jokes. I know that. So there was a couple times I'm sure that he was being coy and trying to be funny. But I do think the sense that I get is that he does love New York.
Mm-hmm.
He's had a great time living in New York City.
He loves the Knicks livery.
Yeah, he really enjoys Madison Square Garden.
Likes the colors.
Yeah, but the Knicks organization, he just doesn't love the direction of, which makes sense.
Yeah.
Which is kind of what we knew. Yeah. I think my favorite part of that was when Edsu said, if he wants to make the playoffs, of course he needs to change clubs. I mean, isn't that just the best?
There you go.
I mean, it's the Knicks' ineptitude is known in Latvia that much that Ed Zeus Kalkoulis, if he wants to make the playoffs, of course he has to change clubs.
Halfway around the world, they know what's going on with the Knicks.
Yep. And I'm looking at pictures of Cēsis or whatever he was saying in Latvia.
Yeah.
I mean, it does not look like a place I want to go. I mean, it looks like an old world, like something in the 1400s with castles. And
yeah, well, I mean, you would expect that. All that stuff is old over there, even in Riga. You got
isn't
a ton
there
of
some
history.
Water in Riga, at least? Didn't I remember looking up Riga and seeing something? This just looks
That's
like
why they go to the countryside. Coachella, they go to the desert, right?
Yeah, I guess. But it's still, I mean, it looks nicer than this. This looks well, like
it's not as old
like,
as
like they're looking for the Holy Grail. You see some of these pictures?
Yeah, I'm looking at it.
Jeez.
It's a lot of history, man. That's cool.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. When you throw some bottles in there, yeah. It's real cool.
You can say that about anywhere.
That's true.
Okay. Coming up next, we'll get Brad Heller back in here with a sports update and the Yankees jumping the gun. Coming right back.
Gio and Jones on CBS Sports Radio.